Hi everyone, and welcome to another Film Impact video tutorial. I'm Jaap Boerhoff, I'm the founder and senior developer of Film Impact Premium Tools, here to show you another logo reveal. So, this logo, I have set it up in Photoshop and set all the graphic elements as separate layers. And if you don't know how to do this, there's a separate video on how to convert an EPS logo to a layered Photoshop file. And you know, you need that when you want to create a logo reveal inside of Premiere. Now, I've already done so. So this is a beautiful layered Photoshop file with all the separate elements and even the text elements. They have been separated out. And let's bring this into Premiere Pro. And so here we've got a beautiful clean sequence. Let's import this particular Photoshop file. So this is the logo. Just import and import as a sequence. So Premiere has built up a sequence with all the separate elements already spread out on separate tracks. So let's show you how that works and how that looked like inside this timeline. So all the layers here, including the background, by the way. So I've got the background, so it's a little bit bluish on the side. And there you have all the different options here. I think the O's are different out. Let's swap them out so we know that they'll look better. So should have done that before. But you know, motion, agency, and I've got four rings and 70 tracks in total. Now, when you look at a logo, it kind of directs you the way it wants to be revealed. So for example, all the rings elements, I mean, these are round objects. So how about a rotation to reveal them? And just start off by the first ring. I'm gonna go to the effects library here, and I'm gonna look for the film impact animations. And in this case, we want to spin things because it's round objects. Let's do a spin and see how that works. Oh, yeah. Yeah, beautiful. Works very well. I mean, it has that overshoot kind of feel. So check that out. You can change that and do a simple a Bezier curve if you find that more elegant. You know, the overshoot is very playful, but sometimes if the company is very, very, you know, not so playful as many companies are, unfortunately, we could just do the Bezier curve and it will slow down and will grab your attention. So grab it. Okay, just select this video transition and go to the second ring and paste it there. And now you've got two objects rotating in the same direction. But let's do a counter rotation. Just turn on reverse angle. See how that works. Oh yeah, that looks good, right? So so I'm gonna do that for the fourth angle. Do that. Yeah, make a copy. So these are the same. This one I'm gonna copy it. Select the endpoint of this ring, and now we've got. Oh yeah, this is good. And I haven't touched any controls. I mean, I could, in fact, change the angle or the amount of rotations it makes. At this stage, it makes four spins. I've set the dolly. You can remove the dolly or not. But what I do find more important is to create more dynamics. And what I mean by that is play with the timing of this particular animation. So the first ring is the first one to reveal. The second one, let's give it a little bit of nudge, as in offsets. Even a one frame or two frame offset will work. So I have the second ring selected, do plus one on the keyboard, and that will actually give it an offset by one. Do the second one, so that would be plus two. This one, but plus three. All right, yeah, we can all do the math. It's simple here. So now, ooh, we need more offset, right? So again, I'm just selecting more. Plus one. Now even plus two. We're gonna do a plus two. Do it right. plus two. And now, I mean, just check if this feels right. I mean, there has to be a little bit of stair. And now, oh yeah, and that feels better. And we can even push this. I mean, more frames are better in this particular case. So again, I'm gonna do plus two, plus two, and the letter, the plus two. See how that works. Ooh, that's pretty good, right? So yeah, I mean, it might even, this is 2 second transition. Let's shorten it to 120, 1 seconds and 20 frames. Just double click the transition, hit 120s, 1 seconds and 20 frames. So there you go. Ooh, yeah, so that will, that will, I mean, it could be even be shorter, right? Too much. Probably. I mean, hey, who can tell? Just by trying. Just try. And hey, this needs to be dynamic. I mean, you could try and play with different ones, different timing options. Oh yeah. Yeah, this is good. It's pretty good. We can even add two and add four, play with different lengths and see how that works for you. Oh yeah. I mean, this all looks playful. And now proceed with the letters. So we've got motion. What will we do with that? We have a block motion. I mean, that will treat an element as a block and it will just create that rotation of a block. We've got it right here. Let's show you all the layers. I'm just hitting the tilde key to reveal them all. And I've got here the motion here. This is the one, all the way just above the background. Now, so what does it do? Oh yeah, that's good, right? And if you find that 2-3D kind of, you can push back the 3D amount in the effects control steps, so which is called depth. You can exaggerate the depth, but you can also lower that down, and let's set it to 20 and see how that looks like. If we're happy, I mean, this is a little bit 3D, as you can see. Let's make it 30 even, and that's adding some 3D, but not too much, right? So again, I'm gonna select this video transition, copy it. Command drag, just select the endpoints here of all the elements, and that will include the agency. I'm not sure if you want to do that. So yeah, let's do the agency. Let's move it aside and work with the motion text first. Going back to the program monitor, and that will reveal it all at once. Oh yeah, motion, and it's got that bounce look, so it's doing a good job. And again, we should play with the timing. So I'm gonna add one frame, just one frame, and for text this usually is enough. I mean, we've seen it with the rings that we needed more frames, but just be gentle as a start. So there you go. Now, see how that works. And that's beautiful. And it's playful, right? And now we're going to do the agency. We could do a reveal as we've seen on... I mean, we could push it and make it reveal beneath the motion. Something I've done with another logo. It works. So... will we do that? Well, why not just treat it as one object? I'm just gonna select them all, nest, and this is the agency text element. And now see what we're gonna do with that. We could do another block motion on this agency element and see how that works. Yep. And pull back the entire 3D animation. So there you go. And I don't want to have it bounce, so let's choose a Bezier. So that will be more, this is good. This is very nice. Okay, cool. So, at this stage, we're rendering full HD on full resolution, and this might be, I mean, depending on the type of graphics card you have, this might be too much for your system. So you need to know that you can just improve your playback speed by setting half resolution temporarily. And yep. And now play with the timing. So let's look at the entire animation. And as you can see, this one takes a lot of time, and then the motion is already there. So let's, but I like the timing between the letters, so that's good. So what we're gonna do, just grab the entire text and move it to a side. And even for a second, 20 frames, 25, something like this. Let's remove the gap here. Okay, let's see how that works. Okay, yeah. Too much. I mean, you have to play with this and think about timing and what you think is right. You can even set it to a quarter playback, because you want to feel the timing. And again, so play it back. That's good. And maybe give this more time to breathe. So this is the motion impacts. And so add 10 frames. And this is, I'm just going to copy paste this transition here and select it. Maybe reveal it sooner. So, yep. And maybe stop the bounce just about the time that this, the last movement of the rings is over, and that will be around here. So play with that. That will be good. Again, we're gonna crank this one up and give it a little bit. Oh no, we said it was good, right? We said it was good. So that will be, this is 110, this is 113, 110. Set it back. I mean, that was, I liked the offset between this was good. So again, okay, beautiful animation, right? And let's add another layer, because I'm a layered guy. You know why? More layers tend to tickle the eyes and tickle the feel. And if a lot is happening at the same time, you kind of don't know what is going on, but that sometimes feels good. Okay, going back, so create another sequence. And again, this is a full HD, you can work with any resolution there. Logo reveal, there you go, logo reveal. And I'm gonna look for all the sequences here in my project. And this one, let's rename it. This is the company logo. And I'm just gonna do a sequence in a sequence. And that will work. Oh yeah, that will work beautifully. So there you go. And now what I meant by adding some layers, I can now add another video transition on this entire animation and see what it sparks. I mean, if it works, it works. If it doesn't work, we'll remove it. But just, I mean, this is all happening so quick. We've done so much already. Distortions. Do a grunge it up. Grunge it up, doll. All right, ooh, woo. See that? I didn't like the flash, but I do like, can you see that? All the textures coming in, and it feels kind of playful. And so select the video transition, go to the FX controls tab, and just remove the flash, because I didn't like the flash here. You've got a flash element here, just here. Let's remove it entirely and see how that works. Oh yeah, feels playful. Let's do another one. Yeah. Ooh, yeah. Maybe too much, but you know, it's worth to play around. And as you can see, I mean, within 10 minutes, we've already done a very, very good job on creating this logo reveal. And Hopefully this works for you. And I want to invite you, if you have created a logo animation using the Film Impact Animation Series, I'd recommend just share it with us. Share it on Facebook, share it on Twitter. Please do, because we love to see what you've created. And hope to see you next time. Bye-bye. Cheers.